Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to VVV Time versus VVV Angry. I don't even know what to say about this. This will be a, I guess, a practice game, if you will. I'm supposed to be testing out some new program here, and we're gonna get started. So we're just gonna get loaded up, and we will get into the MLG Metalopolis map. I think they are preparing for Columbus. I don't really want to upload this because I am afraid of leaking information from both these players. So this will be a little bit interesting. And here we go. So we're finally loaded into the game, and this is the MLG Metalopolis map. And actually, let me there we go. Some fancy new tools for you guys. Here is the new overlay that Blizzard has given us in this new version. So it'll be VVV time here, spawned at the rightmost side of the map, and at the topmost we have VVV Angry. And this is MLG Metalopolis, which means that you cannot spawn close ground positions here. So you can't go around here like this, as you can see that. You can only spawn, here we go, so cross distances and close by air. So any of the close ground that a lot of Zerg players worry about, it's not gonna happen this particular game, since this is the, like I said, the MLG Metalopolis map. So about both these guys, VVV Angry, actually, he plays on the Korean server a lot. I remember him streaming. He did do a very unique build in a clan war against EG. I think it was the finals of SCL Season 1, where he went with a 4-orbital build, and he ended up winning that game. I forgot against who. It might have been Strifecrow or something. And it looks like it's going to be one barracks going now, so standard openings from both these guys. And Time, I remember him very well because he did really well in a lot of those team leagues. Like, he literally would carry them to championships. Like, he would be like the last guy standing and he would just win it. So Angry, knowing that the map, you cannot spawn close ground, he's just gonna see if it's close air, and he's gonna discover quite well. He's gonna guess correctly. So this is Metalopolis. You see your gold expansions here in the middle of the map, and you do have two Zelnaga watchtowers. It's always important if you're a Protoss. Like, I'm not saying that Angry would do this because it's too late to do this, but if you're scouting with your probe, you always want to stop at these towers because you want to see if your Terran player should lift it off into the gold expansion. It's really rare that that happens, but now you never know. So it looks like a couple of gateways going down now. Cybernetic Core. I'm not sure what kind of build Time is going to be going for. Maybe that 3-gate Sentry expand build. Maybe a 4-gate. He is on a 1 gas, and he doesn't have his second gas down yet. It looks like Angry has also gone for a 1-racks fast expansion. I'm a little bit rusty. I've actually been playing a little bit. I'm actually preparing for another tournament. Maybe the Anaheim MLG. I'm not too sure. I haven't really been practicing. Maybe playing Borderlands is a form of practice. Who knows? But we do have both these guys. These guys are high-level players. I think the entire VVV was in Dallas just this past MLG. But I'm not sure on the placement or how close they got to the championship bracket. Like, it gets really hard in the championship bracket because you have to go through like a lot of different players, and you might run into someone like Sheth, who's really good, and that might have been your last game before the championship bracket, so it can be hard. So 3 racks is going down here, so it'll be a 4 racks play. I think it's going to be Marines Marauders at first, and maybe, yeah, probably a super heavy bio play. And here we go. So 5 racks is now a Stalker coming in here to peek, and he will meet that bunker. Doing quite a bit of damage to those shields, and another bunker being placed here. So there's a huge amount of surface area where you can attack from here and from here. Angry could also drop if he wanted to back here where these vents are, and for some reason you can never see behind them, so you need to put a pylon here just in case, so you can see if they dropped over there or not, because sometimes you get surprised and oh god. So here we go. Time is going to be destroying that SCV, completing that bunker, and that bunker should be able to Completed, there we go. So they're gonna finish that bunker, put some marines inside, there we go, and these stalkers will be forced back to go, to go back home. Sorry, a little rusty. It's been a while. So Time has decided, hey, it's going to be a two-gate robotics facility expand, and I'm guessing that he wants the Observer first before Immortal, maybe going to Colossus later on, and there we go, the rally point is the Immortal, or I mean the Observer, sorry. Stalker just going on these watchtowers, you always want control of those watchtowers, and so far, just Marines, no other, nothing else that I can see. He's actually taking his gas now, so there we go, double gas going down. Good placement for that supply depot to prevent void rays or anything to go over there. And here we go. So Time, still stationed just outside Envy Space. He salvaged that bunker because he realized he didn't need it. And so far, lots of marine play. I wonder what he's going to be going up for next. So here we go. The Observer is going to see everything. And here we go. So Techlai, maybe a stim timing push from Angry. He hasn't even started on Marauders yet. I don't even think he has enough gas, no. No, he doesn't, so here we go. And, oh yeah, this is not a replay. You can tell here, because there used to be an overlay I would put, but this is being cast pretty much live and I'm missing the action. A lot of these Marines are catching some of those Stalkers off guard, and it looks like Time will be forced to just attack into these Marines. And it's just a mass Marine build here from Angry, and it looks like there is a sentry out here, but oh my god, this happens to be a perfect counter since these Marines do bypass the Immortal's hardened shield. And here we go, nice micro here from Angry. He's killing off a lot of these Protoss units, and he's gonna try to kite those Zealots. Oh my god, the Immortal just goes down so fast. And wow, these two Stalkers are goners. And here we go, so split here from Angry. He's gonna get, ooh, 2 HP left. He can get him. Go back, go back. Oh, he's trying to micro as hard as he can. He's trying to buy time to warp in. Here we go. As they warp in, they just get killed, and there's a lot more Marines coming in here. And the Observer is actually parked outside the base, but it won't matter because the hardened shields are getting ignored here by these Marines since they do just less than 10 damage, 6 to be exact. And the Immortal finally does go down, and all these pros are just gonna get shot up for free. And there we go. The GG is called, and thank you guys for tuning in.